Okay. Yes.
என்ன ஆசைப்படுற?
Okay, I'll just see what we are saying now. There's a difference in the response of different persons. Human beings have their own mental screens. Okay? The mental screens are actually blocks them from seeing the reality as it is. These mental screens are called what we call as vasanas or impressions. Okay, what is obvious to one person is not at all obvious to another person. Right? Okay. I mean, what seems to be so straightforward and real to one person is not at all real or obvious to another person. And these mental screens are very close to each other. So you cannot know, you cannot find out by yourself. Okay? So these are the mental screens are two types. One is benign and another is malign. Right? So benign means something you think is good. Okay, what is really good for you is not necessarily good for others. Okay? Then you'll never touch those screens. You live with that. Okay? You are happy with that. For example, I'm just giving example, right? For example, somebody spending time with his friend after office hours is a very good, enjoyable passion. It is benign for him. But for his family member, it's malign. They think that he's wasting his time. Okay, his life is getting disturbed. Okay, but he has a mental screen, and he will never be able to come out of that. And it's like what we call as blind spot for us. All of us have a blind spot. Okay? And it's very difficult to come out of the blind spot. Because we think that those aspects of us, those habits of us, are really giving us joy. Maybe they're harming us, we don't know. But somebody else who doesn't have that blind spot can see that very clearly. Right? That person we're seeing, he may have some other blind spot. But this he can see. So this each of us have blind spots, and this is what's called screen of Maya. I call it screen of Maya. And this screen of Maya is very difficult to overcome. Okay? And it's almost impossible. Only the environment, the totality functioning, the circumstances will change. For example, the whole worldview, the way the world was operating, has changed with the coronavirus. There is a certain way of life everybody had. Going to the office, rushing to the office, working in the office, having a big, big building. Now, with the coronavirus, everybody's thinking, is there a big building required? Why can't you work from home? So there is a lot of rethinking happens. So now what will happen? The totality, functioning of the totality brings a changes in the society, changes in the environment. The totality is called Ishvara, the functioning of the totality. Okay? Ishvara's functioning is what brings changes in the society, environment, your circumstances, everything. And that's what makes you wake up. Oh my God, what I am doing? Am I doing right thing? That's called grace, actually. Okay? The grace of Ishvara comes in this form also, in many forms. So unless there is a grace, you will not wake up to your own blind spots. Okay? And that grace comes how? So many times there are so many circumstances in life which change. What you think it valid at one point of time becomes completely invalid. It
Yes,
exposes your blind spot. Now
correct.
that is nothing, that is not because of your doing, please understand. It's because of totality functioning. Your family, your circumstances, everything is changing. That's Ishvara's grace which opens up some blind spot in you, and then you realize, oh my God, I should not have done this. Right? Right? It is not your discovery. It is a grace. Okay? So without this grace, what will happen? Without grace means grace will change the circumstance. The totality changes the circumstance. And the totality is functioning all the time. Everything happening in our life is a totality functioning. Okay? The Ishvara's functioning is what is life all about. We don't understand that. We think of we have independent life. in reality we are part of the totality, and totality whatever is functioning, we are functioning that. So it is very difficult to wake up to the reality with all our blind spots. It's only grace which can wake you up. So what happens in somebody's life is practically because of his prarabdha karma, destiny, what we call as destiny, right? Destiny, another name for destiny in Sanskrit is daiva.
Okay.
Another name for destiny in Sanskrit is called daiva. Destiny is a word which is doesn't give that sense. Daiva means the larger force of nature operating. Okay. So that's operating in your life. Why they operate? Because of your prarabdha karma. Whatever karma you have done, how you interact with the totality in earlier, that interactions will replay or come back in the form of a destiny. Now, why you did something at last earlier at some point of time is because of at that point of time it appeared to be real to you. At that point of time, your understanding vision was that much only. You did unconscious actions, but the unconscious actions also will result in results.
Yeah.
That comes as a karma phala, prarabdha karma. At some point of time, you start waking up from the based on the karma phala. Oh, why did I do this? Why should I do? What should I have done better? Like that, you start thinking. Maybe at that some point of time, some of your blind spots or Maya or the screen of Maya starts collapsing. So that's what is called breaking of the egg of illusion. And if the really egg breaks down, then there's a sort of enlightenment or liberation can happen. Now, that's again a grace. In the sense, it's totality functioning, not an individual working. But individual has to do his work. If without doing individual doing his work, it will not happen. The grace will not happen. It is not just because individual does some work, the grace is it's happening. It's a complex factor of individual and universal playing with each other. Right? So, opens up. Now, there's a difference between the way a jnani and adnani function in a given situation. A jnani in any given situation, any circumstance, whether it's catastrophic or whatever, he is simply a sakshi, witness. And he will be able to respond to the situation in a very appropriate way, the best possible way. It doesn't mean that jnani's actions will give the best result.
Okay.
There's no guarantee. But he can act in a given circumstance with the less amount of disturbance of the mind. What is possible, he will do. Okay. He doesn't get disturbed by what's happening. And he will be able to act what is possible. It doesn't mean that a jnani's actions are 100% perfect. They are not. But his actions are based on less of emotional turbulence.
Okay.
And what is required for the situation. Whereas in case of adnani, he will go through a lot of emotional turbulence. So what is right action also will become a wrong action in his hand because the emotional turbulence. What is to be done also, he'll be confused.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
So this is the difference between jnani and adnani. Jnani's mind is very less cluttered. Okay? And whatever he does with all the good knowledge at that point of time also may not be most appropriate thing, but that's the best what can be done at a given point of time.
Why do you say even that is not most appropriate, Guruji? Because jnani is like the highest benchmark.
No, no, I'm saying.
Even if this action
I'm
is
saying
not,
the body mind complex of jnani is still limited, no?
Okay.
Right? Whatever that limited body mind complex, there may be infinite intelligence at the behind the body mind complex, but ultimately it's the body mind complex which has the limitation of that body mind complex will function. Maybe some vasanas also will be there. Okay.
Right. Yeah.
But only thing what you can say is jnani acts like a sthita pradna, unaffected by the circumstance. Okay. Whereas adnani is totally affected by circumstance and also his own action. Okay.
Yeah.
But when jnani or adnani encounter a different situation, they'll react in a different way. They see somebody suffering. Okay. So adnani may go through emotional turbulence. So that guy is suffering. What will happen to me also? He may go through emotional turbulence. Okay. Also, he may go and help him with a lot of emotional disturbance. And that help whatever help he is doing to that person or himself is both out of emotional disturbance.
Yes.
And in that emotional disturbance, whatever action may be taken may not be very appropriate also.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Or even if you take appropriate action, both still the person will be in a mental clutter.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Whereas in case of a jnani, he sees somebody is in trouble and he knows very well at the given circumstance that person, the trouble is most appropriate thing for happening for him because of the prarabdha karma. So he doesn't blame the situation or blame any circumstance or anything. Okay. He says, yes, that's what can happen. So whereas in case of ajnani, first level is rejection. Why should this happen? Right? Why should this happen to him or happen to me? Whereas jnani says, yes, this is what can happen. This is the meaning of whatever should happen will happen. So jnani accepts it. Once he accepts it, his mind is calm. Now then he doesn't run away from the situation, saying that, oh, this is anyway your prarabdha karma, suffer. He may, to the extent of what is possible, he may help him. That is with the out of compassion.
Okay.
Whereas ajnani's right actions are out of passion, not compassion. The passion disturbs the mind.
Yeah.
In the compassion, the mind is very calm.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Mm-hmm. So this is the difference between jnani and ajnani.
Mm-hmm.
And jnani's actions, whatever possible, at that possible moment, he is doing the best possible. It doesn't mean that it's the best, it is the absolute best possible, or it will give the best result, you can't say.
Yeah, okay.
Right?
Right.
With the body-mind complex, because that jnani's body-mind complex also is subject to prarabdha karma.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So he will do it. But he is not emotionally disturbed, he is very calm. So ajnani acts out of passion, whereas jnani acts out of compassion. In compassion, the mind is calm. There is no emotional turbulence. Okay? So now I will bring in the Ishvara. There are three, jnani, ajnani and Ishvara. In Ishvara, there is no compassion. Ishvara is very like a judge. This is what is to be done. This is what has to happen, this is what will happen, that's all. Right? Ishwara doesn't go out of his bounds. I mean, he goes by more legal book. This is your prarabdha karma, this is what you did, this is what you suffer, take it. Okay?
As in this context, what do you mean by Ishwara, Guruji?
Ishwara is the totality, no? Totality functioning.
Okay.
Totality functioning. See, why prarabdha karma of anybody should fructify at a given point of time?
Yeah.
It is fructifying because of the totality functioning, which is Ishvara.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So there is no law. It's like a law, precise law, like a gravitational force or something. Something what you did earlier will come now. That's all.
Mm-hmm.
There is no, what I'm saying, bypassing or anything. Right? Ishvara is like a very... this is what you did earlier, this is what will happen. The totality is functioning like that. Right? Whereas a jnani, he knows it is what is to happen, what has happened to be happened is the right thing to happen. But jnani is a compassion, which Ishvara doesn't show in that sense. So out of compassion, jnani acts to help him out of the situation. So, in that sense, jnani or sadguru or a realized master is the embodiment of compassion aspect of Ishvara. He will intervene in case of jnani. In case of Ishvara, he will not intervene. Ishvara's grace is providing you the circumstance where your karma will explode or come out. Right? Ishvara's grace comes in the form of sadguru who will intervene in your karma and try to get you out of the way through jnana. That's why it is said, when Brahma writes Hanebaraha, what is that? Vidilikita. He writes with his right hand, whereas a realized master, jnani, sadguru, can wipe it out with this left leg. The reason of wiping out means, through jnana, the clarity will emerge. Karma can be wiped out only through jnana. There's no other way. It's not, there's no excuse from karma. But you will start understanding the cause of the karma, ajnana, and then you start coming out of the karma. In that way, the realized master can help you, can help somebody to come out of karmic cycle. and that is the compassion. So there is a difference in the functioning of Jnani, Ajnani and Ishvara in that way. So any questions?
Nothing, Guruji.